Cystic fibrosis is one of the most common life-threatening genetic disorders in the United States. About 1,000 new cases of cystic fibrosis are diagnosed in the U.S. every year. It's more commonly seen in Caucasians, but sometimes occurs in Hispanics, African Americans, and less frequently, in Asians. Testing for cystic fibrosis is now part of the newborn screening process in Texas. As a healthcare provider, you need to be familiar with cystic fibrosis, the testing process, and how to follow up. Immunoreactive trypsinogen, or IRT, is a protein produced by the pancreas. If two blood samples return with high levels of IRT, or one sample indicates very high IRT levels, this could mean the baby has cystic fibrosis. However, it's important to note that these heightened levels can be caused by other factors. As the child's primary healthcare provider, you need to be ready to talk to parents and address their concerns about these test results. Here's an example of a counseling session with parents whose baby has received an abnormal screen for CF.
Thanks for coming in today. You're here because your pediatrician had referred you to see me because the newborn screening for cystic fibrosis in your child was abnormal. And so I want to talk to you a little bit about what cystic fibrosis is. And as you may already know, it's a genetic condition where there is a mutation or an alteration in the normal genes. And a child often would get that mutation from each parent. In the lungs, it can cause the mucus to be thick, and it increases the risk for recurrent infections. In the GI tract, it can affect how your child absorbs food, and so malnutrition is something that we really want to avoid. And in this regard, certain foods that contain fat becomes an issue. And so if this is a problem, we have medicines that will help break down that food and help improve your child's absorption of those food. Do you have any questions for me?
To clarify, doctor, does our child have cystic fibrosis?
With the newborn screening, having two elevated IRT or immunoreactive trypsinogen level, it's suggestive, but it's not diagnostic. To confirm that diagnosis, we need to do a sweat test. And if that sweat test is abnormal or the sodium chloride concentration is abnormally high, then it becomes more confirmatory, although genetic testing to look at the specific gene mutation will also be helpful.
As the baby's healthcare provider, you may need to arrange for special testing, called a sweat test, to get a more accurate diagnosis. The sweat test is done at a clinic that specializes in the diagnosis and treatment of cystic fibrosis. Treatment for cystic fibrosis is often given by specialists, but as a primary healthcare provider, it's important for you to understand the disorder and its management.
What is the life expectancy of a child with cystic fibrosis?
That's a great question. In the past, when someone was diagnosed with cystic fibrosis, they may not survive their infancy, but more recently, we've made a lot of progress, and in fact, the average lifespan of someone with CF is about 38 years, and we have people who are living much longer than that.
Will she live a normal life?
I think she will, and with proper care and good nutrition and good follow-up, we expect her to have a normal life in every way, except for some changes that will allow her to keep her lungs clean and to make sure that her nutrition is good and her growth and development is good.
What can we do?
The key here is that you are established with a care center that provides specialized care for kids and adults with cystic fibrosis, where we focus on all the issues that we talked about and make sure that we address any infection or identify early, and look at their nutritional status and make sure that we're growing properly. We're doing the airway clearance measures that is suggested. If we're mindful of all those things and we're aggressive, then your child should grow and develop normally. Thanks for coming in today. I think you're in a good place, and we'll have lots of educational material for you, and once the diagnostic testing is in place, we can take the next step.
Treatments vary depending on the stage of the disease and which organs are affected. Most people with cystic fibrosis have trouble with chronic lung problems. Mucus thinning drugs, antibiotics, and daily airway drainage can help decrease constant lung infections. The mucus caused by this disorder can also obstruct the pancreas, stopping the digestive enzymes that help break down and absorb food in the intestines. Oral enzymes and special diets are ways to avoid malnutrition that is often a result of cystic fibrosis. Every day, researchers are looking for better methods of treatment and a cure for cystic fibrosis. In the meantime, testing for this harmful genetic disorder at birth allows families to start treatment immediately. Discovering cystic fibrosis early gives these children a better chance for a longer, healthier life. To learn more about cystic fibrosis and locate a chapter in your area, please visit www.cff.org. And for more information on newborn screening in Texas, please visit www.dshs.state.tx.us/newborn.